I consider it one of the greatest blessings to be part of the children's ministry. Actually, when they called for volunteers to be Sunday school teachers, I saw that as an opportunity to fulfill my childhood dream, because I grew up in India. As a child, I did go to church, but I didn't go to Sunday school. So when this opportunity came up, I saw that as a fulfillment of my desire, a childhood desire. And this year, I'm all by myself as a teacher for the fifth graders. I was explaining to them about how we're all His children, children of God, because of that covenant promise. And immediately, one kid raised his hand, and with confusion evident on his face, he asked, "What is God's skin color?" And I was for a moment taken aback. Why is this question coming up? And immediately, I could understand what his mindset was, because I knew a kid who asked the same question back in India, probably a couple of decades back, and it was me. And I had asked God, "God, do you know my language? Would you like my spicy food? Do you understand how difficult it is to live in a hot tropical place like Madurai or Chennai, my place?" There was this poster of God, I mean God poster, written big letters as God. And the kids had to go paste the post-it on it. And one of the girls, she went and wrote, "God is an awesome American." And when I saw that, immediately, I'm like, no, he's an indescribable Indian. That is to me, because he's my God. So I see that pattern of thinking that he is mine. And I immediately, you know, God helped me understand the tendency behind this, the tendency to associate God with one's skin color, one's language, speaking one's language and eating one's food, is the longing. It reveals the longing of the human mind to have that personal connection with God. And when what these young kids did in the class, it just proves beyond doubt that is the longing, that is the desire, the most natural desire for the human mind. To work with kids is both thrilling and challenging, and as personally I feel the kids are, that's the stage when you put in the word of God into their mind. Probably they wouldn't realize the importance of it at that time. It's the thrill that when I ask the kids in my class to recite the memory verse back to me, and when they do that, I just get this wow, you know, because they are just reciting it and memorizing it. They probably don't know the fullness of that word they are memorizing, but what's in here is the supercomputer. Her name is Kimberly, and she read it. "I don't call you servants. I don't call you Kimberly servant, because the servant does not know the master's business. I call you friend, for whatever I learned from my father, I have made known to you, Kimberly." And after she read it, she said, "Wow, it's personal." You know, that expression, that joy that she showed on her face, that made my day. Yes, girl, that's it. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It's personal. When I just asked them to put that word after you, I mean their name after you, they just read it. "I call you friend. I call you Kimberly friend." And that made that, the joy that she got on her face, I'm like, yes, this is what I want them to know. So that was a wow moment for me, yeah. I see the serving opportunities that is there in this church as, you know, when we get this enlightenment or kind of, oh wow, I've got this faith and I've got to do something, then you share it. And for me, I love talking, you know, and I love teaching. I'm blessed to have this opportunity to be a Sunday school teacher, to work with the kids and just enrich my faith walk too. My name is Malar Ramesh, and I am a disciple of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm.